The wise man built his house upon that rock. He built his house upon that rock, and on that rock he stood. He built his house real good. When the rains, and when the rains came down, the man was safe and sound. The foolish man built his house upon the sand. He built his house upon the sand. It wasn't a very good plan. He was a wishy-washy man. Now sing, when the rains, and when the rains came down, the floods were all around. The wise man built his house upon that rock. He built his house upon that rock, and on that rock he stood. He built his house real good.
Woo! That was a good energetic song, huh?
But through you, I can do anything, and I can do all things, 'cause it's you who gives me strength. Nothing is impossible through you. Blind eyes are open. The strongholds are broken. I'm living by faith. Nothing is impossible.
There you go. Jump around. Have some fun. See, I'm not gonna live
do anything. I can do all things, 'cause it's you who gives me strength. Nothing is impossible through you. Blind eyes are open, the strongholds are broken. I am living by faith. Nothing is impossible. You who gives me strength. Nothing is impossible through you. Blind eyes are open, the strongholds are broken. I am living by faith. Nothing is impossible. It's you who gives me strength. Nothing is impossible through you. Blind eyes are open, the strongholds are broken. I am living by faith. Nothing is impossible.
Can you say, he is so good? So say, God, you're so good. Thank you, Father God. Lord, we worship you. We give you thanks. We give you praise. You are so good to us. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father God. We thank you, the Lord our God and King. His love endures forever. Outstretched arm, his love endures forever. Father God. Boys and girls, close your eyes. Raise your hands. Let's take this time to love on the Lord. We want to focus on just Him and what He says about us, right? Because He calls us lovely. He calls us good. He says a lot of good things about us. And when we're going throughout our day, let's not be distracted by things that are happening, but let's keep our eyes on the Lord. Just keep your eyes closed, your hands raised. Let's stay in His presence. Let's worship Him and love on Him.
We live for You. Hallelujah.
Jesus, a name above every other name. And Jesus, the only one who could ever save. You're worthy of every song you could ever sing. We live for you. Oh, we live for you.
Holy, holy, there is no one like you. There
you, Father God. Boys and girls, raise your hands and say, thank you, Father God. Thank you, Lord, that you are a firm foundation for me to build my life on. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Boys and girls, this is such a good time to love on him, to worship him. He is so good to us. Is he so good to you? Yes, he is. Glory to God. This is an awesome time to just tell him how much he means. So real quick, close your eyes and say, Father God, you mean so much to me. And
I know
that as I yield to you,
you will direct me.
You will tell me where to go.
You will tell me what to do.
And you will help me
to walk on the right path
for my life.
Glory to God.
Boys and girls, this is going to be such a fun children's church we're going to have. Are you ready for it? Good. Well, have a seat, and then I have one quick announcement. Are you ready for this? All right, here it is. Coming soon in 2 weeks. Join us for Camp Spirit Man Boot Camp. Can you guys say that? Camp Spirit Man Boot Camp. Oh, yeah. It's going to be so fun. You can't miss it. It's online. We'll be here 2 weeks. Say it, 2 weeks. Yeah, we'll see you then.
Hi, boys and girls. It's offering time. So get your Bibles out and turn with me to 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 13 and 14. Are you ready? All right, read together with me. For by one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, whether slave or free, and have all been made to drink into one Spirit. For in fact, the body is not one member, but many. So what this is talking about is that we are part of the body of Christ. Just like our regular bodies, we are very similar in the body of Christ. This is a picture of a person. They have feet, they have a head, hands, eyes, and ears. It's very similar to what the body of Christ is like. He is our head, and we are his body. So this person's head, what does it do? That's right, it thinks and it controls the rest of the body parts. Now, what about my hands? Do I hear with my hands? No, that would look really funny with hands for ears on my head though. No, my hands are for picking up my toys. What about my feet? Do I pick up my toys with my feet? No, that's kind of tough too. So just like the head needs the body parts, God also needs us to listen to his still small voice, the Holy Spirit, inside us and obey. And if we're willing, he will direct us to give where we should give. He'll also direct us in other areas of our lives. And when he directs us, if we're obedient, we will have a part in his great plan.
Hey, hey, boys and girls, I'm so excited. Look what I got. Did you hear what Miss Hannah said? She said that you're gonna get to watch Spirit Man Boot Camp online. And guess what? I'm gonna be a counselor there. This is my favorite time of year, and I really like to go to camp. So I got my trunk out, and I'm gonna get all the things out and get them ready for camp, because I like to keep them in here so I know exactly where they are. So let's start getting stuff out. I gotta get ready. Now, the reason I like Spirit Man Boot Camp so much is because it teaches us all about our spirit man. And every year we talk about a verse in Galatians. You know what? Actually, I have my camp Bible. I want to read it to you. This is what we talk about at camp every year. Let me read it to you. It says, I say then, walk in the Spirit, and you shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. For the flesh lusts against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary to one another, so that you do not do the things that you wish." So God is saying He wants us to walk in the Spirit. And He's also telling us that our spirit and our flesh are opposite. So if they're opposite, we don't want to walk in the flesh. We want to walk in the Spirit. And when we go to camp, we get to get our spirit strong and focus on what God wants us to do. Now, have you ever heard of the word your conscience? Well, that is your spirit, man, and that's how God talks to us. That is the communication that He tells us things. He tells us where to go, when to go. Anything that He wants to tell us, He tells us in our spirit, man. And the Bible says that our spirit tells us things and our flesh tells us the exact opposite. And we want to be able to decide which one we should do. Let me show you what else the Bible says about the flesh. We want to be sure that we are following the Spirit. Now, this verse is in 2 Corinthians chapter 10. Let me show you what it says. It says, this is verses 3-5. It says, "For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war according to the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God, for pulling down strongholds, casting down arguments and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, bringing everything into captivity to the obedience of Christ." So it says here that even though we have flesh, we do not have to walk by it. We walk by the Spirit, and it says that we can do it, but we need to stop and cast down those thoughts of the flesh, because your flesh is going to tell you to go the wrong way and your spirit is going to tell you to go the right way. All right, I better get finished packing for camp, but you know what? Look what I have here. I have three bags. 1, 2, 3. That kind of reminds me that we are spirit, soul, and body. Whew. Camp is gonna be so exciting this year. I just can't wait. I'm gonna finish my packing.
Hi, boys and girls. Did you know that you are a three-part being? God made you with three different parts. The first one is our spirit, the second one is our soul, and the third one is our body. Now, I am more than just a body. You are more than just a body. We have a spirit, and it lives on the inside of us. And we are looking at each other through those two windows we call eyes. Our spirit is the part that communes with God. Now, our soul is the part of us that does our thinking. It does the reasoning. And then our body is the part that we can feel. So if I stepped on your foot, you'd feel it. Or if I hit you in the head, you'd feel that too. Now, just like this box, I'm gonna illustrate to you, the outside is our body. It's just a shell. On the inside is our soul, which is the second part of us. And on the deepest part of that, the inside of us is our spirit. Now, this is the part that communes with God. We should always be listening. We should train ourselves to listen to the Spirit of God speaking to our spirit, because He will always direct us in the right way to go.
Boys and girls, it's time to do our confessions. All right, repeat after me. I am the righteousness of God in Christ. Good job. All right, now do the actions if you know them. I'm quick, I'm sharp, I'm bright, good looking, very rich, and a blessing. And I'm a doer of the Word of God. Good job.
Hi, boys and girls. It's time for our Bible reading. But first, let's do our Bible confessions. So get your Bibles out. You got them? All right, raise them up and repeat after me. Say, this is my Bible. It is the Word of God. I am what God says I am. I can do what God says I can do. And I can be what God says I can be. Awesome job. All right, now open your Bibles up to 1 Thessalonians 5:23. You got it? All right, let's read together. It says, we pray that God himself, the God of peace, will make you pure, belonging only to him. We pray that your whole self, spirit, soul, and body will be kept safe and be blameless when our Lord Jesus Christ comes. You know, that's actually a prayer. Let's pray that over ourselves. Pray with me. Say, we pray, Father God, the God of peace, that you will make us pure, belonging only to you. We pray that our whole self, spirit, soul, and body will be kept safe and be blameless when our Lord Jesus Christ comes. In Jesus' name, amen. Now that we prayed that, in Jesus' name, should be expecting to receive just that, because we prayed it and we believe that we receive it. So confess this after me. Say, we are some of the most spiritually aware and spirit-led kids of our generation on the planet. Good job.
Boys and girls, this song has a lot to do with what we've been learning today. I think you know it, so why don't you sing along?
Follow your heart and not your understanding. Follow your heart and not your reasoning. Follow your heart and listen to your spirit. Follow your heart. Follow your heart.
Sing it again.
Follow your heart and not your understanding. Follow your heart and not your reasoning. Follow your heart and listen to your spirit. Follow your heart. Follow your heart.
One more time.
Follow your heart and not your understanding. Follow your heart and not your reasoning. Follow your heart and listen to your spirit. Follow your heart. Follow your heart.
Follow your heart.
Follow your heart. Follow your heart.
One more time.
Follow your heart. Follow your heart.
Good job!
Hi, boys and girls. I brought my friend Rover here today because we're going to talk about our spirit and our body. So our spirit lives inside of our body, just like I am inside of this costume. And without our spirit, our body would just be an empty shell. Just like if I take my hand out of this glove, it's just limp and lifeless. Now we need our body to live on this earth, right? So let's all take a breath. But is our body who we are? No, it's not. It's our spirit. And just like our spirit is inside of us, I'm inside of this costume. But our spirit looks outside of our body through our eyes, just like I was looking through this costume's eyes. So let's turn today in our Bible to Acts chapter 17. In verse 28, you guys all have your Bibles. All right, the first part of verse 28 says, "For in him we live and move and have our being." So we live in this body, but it's God that gives us life to our spirit. So remember, it's your spirit that lives and communes with God.
Hey friends! Wow, I have got a fun craft activity for us today. Today we are going to make wristbands. Would you like to make a wristband today? Awesome! Well, what you're gonna need for a wristband is some shoelaces. Do you have any shoelaces at your house? Look at these fun ones I found in the cabinet. Aren't those fun? Well, I was found them, they were extra, so I was able to cut them up. If you find some shoelaces, make sure and ask your mom if you can cut them up. If you don't have extra shoelaces, you could use ribbon or string. Whatever you find will be great for your wristband, as long as it's colors that you like, because you're gonna wanna wear it. Now, the reason we are actually making wristbands today is because they have three parts. Can you see those three parts? Well, that reminds me of our spirit, our soul, and our body. Do you know that's how God made us? We've been talking about that today. So when you wear your wristband, you can remember that you have a spirit, a soul, and a body. All right, let me show you how to make this wristband. You're gonna need a little bit of tape. This is gonna be so helpful. I have two shoelaces of the same color, so I'm gonna put them on the outside. I'm gonna put my fancy color in the middle. Now I'm gonna group them together and I'm gonna tape them to the table. Again, ask your mom if you can put tape on the table, or you can also put tape maybe outside on the concrete. That would be okay too. We don't wanna mess up your mom's nice table. All right, so we have our three parts here. What are we gonna do? We're gonna braid it. Let me show you, it's so simple. You're gonna take the outside piece and you're gonna go inside to the middle. Okay, that's step one. Now you're gonna go for this outside piece. Go to the center. That was step two. Now here's step three, take this outside piece. Go to the center. Are you seeing the pattern? We just go outside to the middle, outside to the middle. And look, it's braiding, and you just tighten it up a little bit. Oops, came out of my tape here. Hold on. That might happen to you, but that's all right, you just try again. Miss Megan really likes to braid things. You can braid anything. So you just go outside center. Now, you can just keep on keeping on. And while you are making your wristband, boys and girls, you can just be thinking, I know a God who created me, and I know a God who speaks to my spirit. That's how we hear from God. Because God is spirit, and he speaks to us in our spirit. Even though we have flesh on the outside, our spirit is on the inside, and that's what hears from God. And it's not hard to hear from God. Okay, oh, are you seeing me? I'm braiding. Continuing, you just go outside in. I just got carried away. I like to braid so much. All right, outside in. If this looks a little confusing to you, keep practicing. Come back and watch again and you can see, or ask a friend or a mom to help you braid it. Outside in. All right, we're getting to the end of our wristband. This is gonna be so cute. What are we gonna do at the end? All right, so we're gonna take this, and we wanna leave it a little bit braided, and we take our tape side. Now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna wrap it around our wrist. I think it's gonna be good. Look, I even made it a little bit longer than I needed to, and that is good because I'll have room. So, I am going to take this out. There we go. And I'm gonna tie these. You can tie them or you can tape them, whatever is easiest for you. We're gonna wrap it around our wrist. If you would prefer to make a lanyard, that'd be really fun, or something for your water bottle. I just want you to remember that anytime you're looking at it, you remember the three parts that God made you. Do you see it? Awesome! Now you might need a friend to help you tie it on. You take this little knot, I'll show you off of my wrist, and you will tie it right here. You can also tape it. Duct tape works great. I made one earlier and I used duct tape for it, and it was perfect. Oh, come on. Here we go. All right, oh, there it is. All right, let me get this on. Now, did I make it too small? No, it's on, it's ready. I want it to stay on forever. All right, oh, boys and girls, look at that. That's our fun wristband. Enjoy braiding and remembering that God made you into three parts, spirit, soul, and body.
Boys and girls, we have learned so much today, but we don't want to leave today without giving you the opportunity to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. So if you've never asked him into your heart, I want you to close your eyes and raise your hand and repeat after me. Say, Father God, I know that you sent Jesus to die on the cross for me, and he was risen 3 days later, and now he's in heaven with you. And Jesus, I ask you to be Lord and Savior over my life. And I thank you that you will lead and guide me for the rest of my life. Amen. Praise God. How exciting. Boys and girls, the angels in heaven are rejoicing. I'm rejoicing. This is awesome. You are now a part of God's family, and you have Jesus in your life forever. Now don't forget, in 2 weeks, we have Camp Spirit Man Boot Camp, and it's gonna be awesome. And you should definitely be here because we're gonna talk about all kinds of fun stuff. We'll see you then.
All right, boys and girls, I hope you were listening to Miss Hannah. 2 weeks, we're going to start Camp Spirit Man Boot Camp. We're gonna pump up your spirits. Are you ready? Something we always say at camp. I want you to repeat it after me, okay? I am a spirit. That's right. I have a soul, and I live in a body. Very good, boys and girls. Make sure you tune in. 2 weeks, okay? We're gonna start it.
Toby, that's the camp your dad and I went to. I think you should go to camp this summer.
Oh man, I don't want to go to camp. I already had this whole summer planned out. I was going to reach max level on Ninja Llamas.
Hey, Muscle Man.
Hey, Toby. Welcome back.
I'm here for my next workout.
All right. Well, today, we're going to be focusing on your arm muscles. Get them nice and strong.
I'm excited to get stronger.
You know, I know all this extra work's really going to help you get strong, and you're really going to notice a difference.
I've never been more ready than I am this year.
That's what I like to hear. All right. Got a good plan for us today. We're going to work on these.
All right.
Take that. I'm going to give you 10 good reps to start with. Are you ready?
Yeah.
All right. Here we go. One. Two, three. Oh yeah, feel the burn. Feel those muscles go. Feel them go, yeah, there you go. Here we go, I forgot where we are, but let's call that 10 right there. Yeah, that was really good. But I feel like you had something else on your mind.
Yeah, I guess. I'm thinking about going to this camp called Spirit Man Boot Camp. Have you ever heard of it?
I have heard of it. You know, I've seen the commercials for it, and my friend was telling me how great it was whenever they got back.
Yeah, that's what my mom says.
You know, moms, they usually know what's best for us.
Yeah.
So maybe you should listen to her and give it a try.
Sounds like a plan. I can always trust you in our program to help me grow my muscles.
That's right. We're going to grow those muscles. Now drop and give me 20. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Hey Mom, what you doing?
I'm just getting supper ready. I'm gonna make salad and my famous salad dressing.
Oh, that is my favorite. But how do you make it?
You wanna watch me? All right, first you add the oil. Then you add vinegar. And my special spices.
Mm-hmm.
Then you shake it up. Hey, do you notice something about this?
Well, the oil and the vinegar are mixing together.
That's kind of like your flesh and your spirit. The flesh and the spirit are in opposition to each other. Galatians When we were at camp, we learned Galatians 5, 16, and 17, and it said, if we walk by the Spirit, we will not do the things of the flesh. Mm. The flesh is always warring against or in opposition to the Spirit. Do you know the voice of the Spirit and the voice of the flesh?
No, not really.
I think it would be good for you to go to camp, and you would learn about that.
I don't really know. I'll think about it.
Do you know how baby animals in the wild know their mothers? They know them by their voice or the unique sounds they make. Monkeys are exceptionally good at this. Most monkeys can tell the difference between the voices of different individuals in their social group. Vervet monkey mothers can pick out their young by voice alone. Vervet monkeys can also recognize one another by relationships. In experiments in which the call of one vervet baby is played to the troop, many of the monkeys look in the direction of the mother whose baby's voice was played. They know that that call is for that particular monkey's mother because they know that baby's voice. Likewise, the baby's monkey knows the sound of its mother's voice, and it will respond.
That sounds like a verse I read in the Bible. My sheep hear my voice and I know them and they follow me. God, can you hear me? Can I hear you? Surely you made us greater than monkeys. Are you trying to tell me something?